Oh man, finished another session. Today I want to talk to you about, wait one sec, okay. I want to talk to you about this female influencer from Dubai who took a photograph in a business class standing there, and then, you know, somebody else took a photograph and said she's in economy class. Okay, I'll give my thoughts about it and why it is a good publicity stunt, but a very bad strategy long term. Short term good, long term very bad, and I'll tell you why. Okay, first and foremost, let me give you random comments. I mean, her photograph, when she showed in the business class, I felt it was like photoshopped. Like she didn't look normal. The proportions look like super wide and super narrow waist and super wide ass. And I was like, is this some kind of cartoonish Photoshop or something? Obviously, after it got reported on various news channels, when it got reported on Daily Mail Online and BuzzFeed and all that, finish. She reached a tipping point where she is now viral. You can be rest assured, at least 10 million people must have viewed that. Okay. Now, if you look at it from the standpoint of free publicity, okay, that publicity itself is worth $100 million. That is how much she has managed to generate, means not generate for herself, spend she would have spent if she had to gain this kind of attention or notoriety. Okay. Now, I agree with you. I agree with all the people who say, fuck, she went viral. Oh, what a smart female. Some people are saying, this is just fake. She planned this out to get free publicity. Possibly, there is a possibility. Many people do this. They show that they did a mistake and then it goes viral. Then there are some others who say that, you know, even stupidity makes you famous, which is true. The more dumb you are, sometimes you get more famous. That's why people do cringe-worthy stuff like that guy on X Factor, you see people singing cringy stuff like, you know, that guy sang, she bangs, she bangs, and then you become viral because of something stupid. Okay. Now, obviously, because all the attention, I was curious to see her profile. So she succeeded in that. Under normal circumstances, I wouldn't have checked her profile. And yes, I also did share with my groups. So she succeeded there also. But now, let's shut down this part of the argument. Because I agree. She got millions of dollars worth of free publicity. Now she's known. But now let's check the other side, the flip side. What is a drawback? And the reason I want to speak on the drawback is because there are so many youngsters in my group who are saying, wow, fuck man, she has made it and this and that. And there's a kind of admiration for her. Now, you know, it is giving the wrong message to our, to the future generation. Not as much as the people who want to be famous today, but rather for the ones who aspire to be famous. This is a very wrong message that they are getting. Okay, if I do something stupid, cringeworthy or horrible, or and if I get famous, yes, you know, because now the goal will be, how can I get viral? You know, that is why if you actually look at it, what is the tagline? Oh, this person has gone viral. It's become so cool to be viral. And I don't blame anyone. The reason I don't blame anyone is because today's metrics are measured in terms of numbers. Why do you think so many people, the people who don't like me or the people who want to be critical about me, they say, oh, you have only 40,000 subscribers. Ha ha ha. What the fuck are you talking? 40,000 subscribers. Do you know this guy XYZ has 10 million subscribers. Fine. Then people also say, hey, what the fuck, man? You have only 100 views. 100 views on a fucking video and you think you're a big shot. Ha, ha, ha. See? And they are right. They are right. These are the metrics by which people measure your value. Oh, how many views? How many subscribers? And I would be lying if I tell you that social media content creators are not focused on these numbers, because the more these numbers are in terms of you know what they show, it's not views, by the way, it's not views, it is engagement. Okay, let that, I'll speak about it in a little later. The more these numbers are, the greater your chance of getting paid by the algorithm. The second one is, the bigger your followers or the bigger the numbers of views, the bigger your clout. Like when you go and meet someone and they check how many followers or views you have. If you have, let's say one person has 1 million views per video and I have 100, obviously they'll be like, fuck, you're a superstar. They'll not say, oh, you're a superstar with 100 people viewing my videos. Okay. So that is why almost everybody focuses on these metrics, numbers. You know, in the olden days, it was, in your school, in your exam, who got the highest? Oh, 100 out of 100, wow, he's the best. 98 out of 100 is, not there, but 100 out of 100 is better. Oh, she got 68, he got 72, oh, he's better. So the numbers has always been a measurement of someone's success. Even bodybuilding, oh, he can do 12 reps, oh, he can do 15. No, I mean, he can do 10 kilos, or he can do 20, or he can lift 100, or he can lift 300. So greater the number, we have always associated more the success. Okay, that's why even bank balance. Oh, he purchased a 10 million condo. This guy purchased 100 million condo. Why do you think we always focus on the world's richest man? Oh, Elon Musk has, example, 72 billion. Oh, this guy has 93 billion. Oh, wow, he's bigger. Okay. So we as human beings in a society have, you know, kind of been programmed that the bigger the number, the better. So which is why the same is being targeted by people on social media. But now the problem is, it's people, you know, they have this habit of cheating the system. They like to cheat the system to inflate the numbers. Like they say, you know, fake it till you make it. Why do you think people are posing next to Lamborghinis and expensive houses and 2-3 girls and sitting on a jet plane and showing that, oh, I'm a sophisticated guy? So it's like fake it till you make it kind of scenario. Now the problem is, people generally want success easy. The easier they can get the success, the better it is. That is why do you think get six-pack abs in 6 weeks? If someone is selling, get 6-pack abs in 6 months versus somebody who says 6-pack abs in 6 weeks, the guy with 6 weeks will get more followers. And if someone comes and says, get it in 6 days, obviously people will be more inclined. Oh, why the fuck should I wait 6 weeks? I'll go for 6 days. And that is where if you have one pill and you say, you lose half your body weight in 6 hours, they'll buy that. People like the shortest way, the shortest route to achieving their goals. We like, that's why they call it, no? Immediate, instant gratification. Okay. So, all of us are looking for that shortcut to success. Shortcut to making millions. That, why do you think Bitcoin is famous or cryptocurrency is so talked about? Oh, I invested 100, I got million. Wow. Oh, I got a lottery ticket. Fuck, wow. So, the old-fashioned way of working hard 20 years or 30 years towards your dream versus one guy who did it in 1 year. The one guy who did it in 1 year is admired. Nobody wants, oh fuck, you waited 30 years, fuck you man, I'll do it in 1 year. So this is the kind of society we live in. Now because of this, today's younger generation is desperately seeking out ways and means to achieve that success fast. And they do ridiculous things. Like for example, just Google search. I don't know. Why do you think the girl licked the toilet bowl? You know, the commode, the, you know, potty or where you sit down to shit. Okay. She was licking that area where people put their bums. They put their sweaty legs. And she was licking it and taking a photo or video. And she went viral. And later on she said, oh, I just want to clarify. I didn't lick it dirty. I cleaned it and licked it. But ask yourself, is this normal behavior? Licking the rim of a toilet. Okay. Let's not go that extreme. Let's look at this YouTuber from India who tied his dog with helium balloons to lift it up. Why do you think he did that? Do you think that this is... Sadika, do you think this is normal behavior? How many of us tie animals and put in a helium balloon? When you're small kids, maybe we'll do it out of stupidity. But why do you think we do it today? Why do you think these prank videos? Oh, he kissed a girl and he touched the girl's bum and... Oh, it's a prank video. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, you got something. Hey, you want to fight and this and that. And they get socked and they show these prank videos. Oh, they put a cake on someone's face. Why do you think people do all this ridiculous nonsense? Like TikTok, why do they think these girls... See, look at the way people are trying to achieve success. Young girls, young small girls coming on TikTok and they're biting their lip and putting their finger in their mouth and doing this and, you know, moving their hands towards their waist. I mean, the trouser is really as down as possible. They're showing their body, their abs. Some of them are, they're having their, I don't know, you call it a tank top or whatever, where it's nearly up to where you can see the curvature of their breasts, and they're doing this way, that way, they're dancing. I know, don't get any hard on looking at me. but they're doing all this and some beat and something they're dancing. And just imagine why people are doing all this. Because they want followers. Because they want to feel special. Oh, I have 1 million followers. Oh, fuck you, I'll try to get more. But then in order to get more, you have to push the envelope. You have to do one bit more than the other. I'll give you a small example. This I shared with the people in my group. This female from Dubai, I've known her because she was my client before. And she gave me this big sob story about men being stupid. Her husband dumped her and she has a kid and all blah, blah, blah. Big story she gave me. Fine. And she really looks like a cute girl, really cute. Single mother. I think now she has two children or something. So nice female. So she told me she went through a very tough time in this and that, and she's trying to make ends meet. Okay. It has been years since I spoke to her. She's my friend on social media. I'll not tell you which one. Yesterday, this happened yesterday. I saw her put a photograph of her wearing a nightgown, folding her hands. And this nightgown, the top, her breasts are, you can see her breasts and you can see her nipples. It's see-through. It's so thin. And she's folding her arms and some motivational nonsense. Dare to be your authentic self or your inner self or something like that. She's talking. And she, this way. And you should see the number of comments, likes and, oh, babe, you're so hot. Oh, I love you. Oh, you're amazing. You inspire me. This, that, all that bullshit. Oh, hotness and, okay. Now, just think about it. A mother, okay? She's showing herself naked for the world. Now, who is she showing it to? Is she showing it to her boyfriend? No. Is she showing it to her fans? No, it's not her only fans. She's showing it to the world. And a world where you get roadside people, you get desperate people, you get animals. And they're like, oh, wow, oh, babes, you're so hot. And I'm pretty sure someone who has, you know, fantasizes her must be looking at that photograph and masturbating. Okay. Just imagine. I'm asking, just imagine someone goes to that child and say, oh, your mother. Oh, man, I get... Whatever, think of any indecent statement. Imagine some boy or girl when you're growing up, you're going to school, and they say, oh, your mother, you know, that this porn MILF and all that, whatever, I can't get the full form right now. Okay, for some people in the Western society, this is, wow, fucking cool, man, she's a porn star. Fine, if that is your agenda, hats off to you, you have achieved it. But the fact is, most of these so-called females who show their bodies, they will never attain that kind of success of being a million-dollar star. They'll be relegated to someone paying them money per month, whatever, have sugar daddies. And that's what these influencers are aiming for. But my main concern is the fascination that today's youth have towards this. I mean, just think how many youngsters are watching social media and they are seeing this young, small boys. In my group, I have 18-year-old, 19-year-olds. I've created a separate group and I'm removing youngsters from my main group and putting them into this small group because I don't want them to get wrong ideas when mature content is being shared. These boys are like, oh, just imagine a 18-year-old boy. I don't think I have younger than that in my groups. Just an 18-year-old boy saying, oh, MILF, and oh, I'd love to shag this mama, or if anyone's mother is so hot, I'll shag her. Just think. And then you have small girls who says, you know, this guy, oh, this man is 40-year-old, 50-year-old, he's so hot. Oh, I would love for him to do me. And what? Fine, if you're looking at it from an erotic sense, great. Yay, good. You know, in our fantasies, we have all these fantasies. That's why even when I see porn, sometimes I see like a thin girl, skinny girl, young girl. I don't see grandma. I see a young girl. Okay, in terms of a porn fantasy, yes. Real life? Real life, sad to say, there are some people who look at small youngsters and children. Thankfully, for me, I don't have that disease. But see the message it's giving youngsters today. Now for this girl, this particular model who showed her body and whatever, I'll tell you what the problem is. Now, yes, she got viral, she got famous. But now what kind of an audience is she attracted? If you check her Instagram, nothing but boobs and ass shots. Every photograph is showing her cleavage, showing her ass. I mean, the amount of creative thought that goes into today, how can I show my ass from which angle? How can I bend? How can I show my breasts? I have these females on Facebook who add me up. Every photograph is boobs, ass, boobs and ass shot. Every photograph. Their only call to fame is your boobs and your ass. And obviously they say, oh, I'm a model. That's the definition that they give. Oh, I'm a model. Oh, authentic self, or be true to yourself. I've seen girls who, when they're sitting on the beach, and they'll open their legs. Like they're looking at the other side. Oh, look at the freedom, and legs are open. We are not dumb, man. You have this nice little panty or a nice little bikini that is covering your, you know, that camel toe area. Just perfect. I mean, are we stupid? You think you don't know that you are opened your legs to show, or when you're showing your bum shot, you make sure that your thong is nicely in your ass. You think we don't know that? You expect us to believe you're not aware of the fact that you're showing your bum? Look, if you're an adult and you want to show your bum, you want to show your boobs, your body, it's your life. I'm not going to appear holier than thou. Even I have done things to gain attention. I put tattoos on my face. Each to his own. But now the long term. Short term, yes, you got famous. Long term, now long term what? See, here's where the problem is. Long term, the Yes, you have so many people who are looking at your boobs, your ass, your body. But where is the engagement? Apart from, oh wow, oh I love you, oh you're so hot, oh this. What kind of engagement is this? Who's your target audience? Your target audience is desperate men. Desperate men who, when they see any girl's boobs and ass, they get... So if your sponsor is Durex or Viagra, fine, you have achieved an objective. Those guys will see. But you think any respectable brand will want to associate with you? Unless, of course, you're Kim Kardashian. No. And if people Google search your name, your call to fame is what? Your call to fame is, oh, this is a dumb bitch who tried to flaunt that she's in business class, but she sits in economy. Ha ha ha. What kind of respect will you get among your peers? Okay, dumb fucks who are sitting together. Wow, you got viral. Oh, wow. Oh, that's so cool. Let's do something. No, with dumb bimbos, they'll admire this. But people whose success is organic, who have worked hard creating meaningful content, they'll not admire you. Like, you seriously think a brand like Gucci or a brand like Givenchy or Prado or I don't know, Versace, they're going to look, wow. Oh, she couldn't afford a business class, she sat in economy class, she's our model because she went viral. No, what? You think Pepsi is going to sponsor? No. Which brand? Here's my question to you. Would you associate your name with this person who's known as a fake, who's known as a wannabe? Would you take a photograph with her as, oh, this is my friend? They look at you and laugh. It's like being famous for being a pedophile or a rapist, okay? And you're standing next to him, oh, my best friend. People will say, man, you must be fucking sick to have friends like this. See, if you are living in a bubble or a world where just your numbers mean a lot to you, views and followers, you have achieved your target. But now the question is, what's next? Fine, you came on the media, you got famous. Now what is next? What are you going to be known for? What new stunt are you going to pull? Because you know, the media has this habit. They'll talk about you once for the one big thing that you did. They'll not talk about you again because you're old news. They want something new. They want something fresh. So if tomorrow one other female takes a photograph, business class, and then she's caught in economy class, they'll be, all these influencers are the same, man. Fuck them. So what will you do next? See, that is where I tell people, no? Do something meaningful, slow and steady. Build your foundation strong. It's a painfully long process, but one that is so robust, nobody can shake you. I'll admit one thing. If I was young, most probably I would have been attracted to this route. But I can assure you, it would have destroyed my foundation. I started my brand now, on the public platform at the age of 40, where I'm a little bit more grounded than I would be in my 20s. And yes, my views are only 100 and subscribers are every day, a few are being added up. It's slow, but it's meaningful. Because the ones who engage with me, they are true fans. And through these true fans, I earn my livelihood because my earnings are not views and subscribers. My earnings are taking my professional service. So this is more like a marketing tool for me, for my core business. So I have to be very careful. What message am I putting out there? What content am I talking about? And am I being true to myself? Like they say, you know, they use this word, authentic self, and they misuse this term. I would just say, keep it real, you know? Even if your opinion is unpopular, keep it real. Don't be fake. Anyway, for me, what this female did is short-term wow, long-term suicide. And her journey towards being a boobs and ass model Congrats. You'll get to see some more people admire your boobs and your ass. Lust for you and put those desperate comments. Hope you make money out of it. At the end of the day, why else we're doing all this? On money, right? We have to pay our bills. Anyway, this is what I wanted to say. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Okay. Feel free. Tell me if I'm wrong. Guys, take care. This is me signing off. Ciao.